All right. Andrew Doviak says, question is, to combat the Anderson crowd, how can you prove the Jewish people in Israel today are the continuants of the Old Testament Jewish nation, not the synagogue of Satan, as he teaches? Andrew Doviak's a friend of the broadcast, so we know this is asked in a good spirit. Brother Grady, how do you respond to that?
Well, anyone that knows anything about the history of Palestine knows that there has always been a Jewish remnant in that land. Now, the Romans didn't chase everybody out. They didn't yank them all out during the Assyrian dispersion. I mean, they left some in the land, and the Romans did the same thing. So there's been a continuous Arab-Jewish presence, Arabs and Jews together there through the centuries, but especially the Jews. The majority of them were up in the Sea of Galilee region and in Jerusalem proper. But there's no question that there's been Jews there through the centuries, unbroken line. I don't know if anybody disputes that, any secular historian.
The only people that really reject that are the replacement theologians. Is that correct? I mean, there's no other major that I know of, them and the Palestinians and maybe the Catholics,
Yeah.
So, and it's amazing, how God's word clearly says that the Jews, I mean, how many verses are there that talk about the Jews being regathered, being put back in the land? And so in order for the Jews to not to exist anymore, the Bible would have to be lying.
That's correct.
So there you go.
There was a Jewish legal scholar, Ernst Frankenstein, and he wrote a book on, I have cited in my book, I've 750 books in the bibliography, and he came from a legal perspective that the Jews never renounced their land. They were thrust out forcibly by an invading army, and that empire has ceased to exist, and those Jews have a legal right to their land.
Mm.
And that's been a matter of record for years. I mean, it's just something that you don't want to confuse people with facts, but you can, all of these things are, all of these things are documentable. They legally have a right to their homeland.
Wow. Amen. 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 Let me just make sure your Bible's not missing our wire up there. No, you're good. You're fine. All right, let's move along here. King James Bible says the Stevies will use Ecclesiastes 3:21, LOL, to prove Old Testament saints went to the third heaven. What is your take on this mess? So, Brother Grady, maybe let me get you up to speed here. The Stevies deny that Old Testament saints went to paradise. They don't believe in any paradise. They believe they just went straight to heaven. What is your take? Let's read Ecclesiastes chapter 3.
I got it right here.
All right, read on, Brother Randy.
All right. The Bible says, who knoweth the spirit of man that goeth upward and the spirit of the beast that goeth downward to the earth?
I know how to answer that. Good. You go ahead.
You go ahead.
You got anything on it?
No, just don't take anything they say serious. Why bother?
In their face.
Okay, so let me give you this. The man is a tripart being. 1 Thessalonians 5:23, we're a body, soul, and spirit, okay? Now, the Bible says the body goes into the ground. Obviously, the body decays. We're waiting on the redemption of the body. The soul is what lives on forever, either in heaven or hell. That has a form, the soulless body of the man in hell, Luke 16. Lazarus, all that story. Then the spirit, though, the spirit is what gives the body life. James chapter number 2 says that the body without the spirit is dead. That's verse 28. And Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 7 says that the spirit, when a man dies, the spirit returns to God that gave it. That's the soul, that's lost or saved. The spirit of the Lord is the life-giving source that makes our heart tick, the electric impulses in the brain. So if a lost man dies, his body goes in the ground, his soul goes to hell, and his spirit returns back to God, which gave it. Ecclesiastes 3:21 nowhere proves that Old Testament saints went to heaven. And my goodness, what a dishonest way of using the scriptures there to prove some kind of heresy. Anyway, anybody got anything to add to that?
I kind of agree with that.